Okay, so in our notebooks, I'm on page 31. And we are going to put our objective at the top of this page. I want you guys to write it as an I can statement. I can use scale factor with proportions. So when we're using this objective, we have to think about what does scale factor mean? And I'm going to put my book under so you guys can see a picture here. See if I can zoom in a bit. This is a really cool building in New York City called the Guggenheim Museum. And this here is a blueprint of the museum. Do you guys see that? Mm-hmm. So this is the actual building, which is 4 stories tall and could never fit on a piece of paper. But this drawing is drawn to scale. What that means is it was shrunk down the same amount for every single part. Okay? How many of you know somebody who's built models of things? Have you guys ever seen like Lego models of, do you guys know what I'm talking about? It wouldn't make any sense if somebody did like a Lego model of the Space Needle. And they shrunk down the parts in different amounts. Everything has to be shrunk down the same amount, or it doesn't look like a Space Needle when you're done, right? I was gonna bring in an airplane model that I have at home that could sit right here on this desk, but I left it at home and I'm so frustrated. And it's about this big, and it's a model of an actual airline, which, like the wing of an airline wouldn't even fit in our classroom, right? But my model is shrunk down exactly the same amount on every single piece. Every window, every wheel, every little part is shrunk exactly the same amount. Copy machines do this automatically. You know, when you said to make an enlargement a copy machine, or if we're doing it even here, when I'm doing this with my mouse, it's moving out a certain amount, and the entire image is moving with that same percentage. That's really what a scale factor is doing. So since my book is already under here, let's take a look at the kind of work you're gonna do today. We're gonna be identifying what is the scale factor. And if you notice, we have a race car and its model. We're looking at, in this case, just length and height, but we could have looked at like the length and width of the windshield or a windshield wiper or a door handle. But if we're looking at the whole model car in real life, and that's what's the first one here, it's always the real life, and then the model's coming second. And here's how it's being compared. This is the length in inches of the race car. Here's the length in inches of the model. Here's the height of the race car and the height of the model. Notice we have words here, right? We're still doing our word ratio and we're simplifying it. So what this is saying here, let's see if I can autofocus and get a little better image. Here's the model length. It's 11, where the race car is 132. And that gets reduced down to 1 to 12. That means that the real race car is 12 times bigger than the model, or that the model was shrunk down 12 times less. And that's what a scale factor is. It's that ratio, see right here, of this model which is not going to be the case for all of them. And we'll do a couple problems together in a couple minutes. Okay? So let me write down a problem, and I want you guys to write it with me in your notebook. We'll do a simple version. We're going to do just height in inches. Of a very famous statue. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm zoomed way in and couldn't see that you guys couldn't see. There's what I've got. Height in inches of the Statue of Liberty. We're gonna make our own little table here. And somebody went to New York City and bought a model of the Statue of Liberty. And we're gonna compare that model's height to the real height. Okay? The real Statue of Liberty is 1,824 inches tall. The model is 8. This is related to the work you guys have been doing with proportion word problems, but instead of us setting up a word ratio and a known ratio and an unknown, we're still going to do the word ratio and the known ratio. The last one, though, is not going to be unknown. It's going to be the reduced version of this. Okay? So let's start here with our word. We are comparing the model to the real. And that's going to work for most of your ratios here. Model compared to real. What do we know? We know that the model is 8 and the real is 1,824. Our final ratio is going to be the scale factor, and that's where we reduce it. And when you guys are back in your seats working, you're going to be able to use a calculator. The best thing to do, we've got the 8 here, and we really want that 8 to go down to 1. So we're going to divide it into this. So we're going to do 1,824 divided by 8 gives us 228. So you want to divide both by the model's number, and that will give you your scale factor. And what does this mean? It means that the real Statue of Liberty is 228 times as big as that little 8-inch model of it. Okay? Okay, I'm going to give you guys a couple of quick examples here without us having to pull out the book. How about a problem where we have a photograph that's enlarged and made into a poster? The poster is 20 and a half inches, so let's write down some of these measurements. Poster is 20.5 inches by 36 inches. And we're being given the scale factor, we'll just shorten that to SF for scale factor, is 5/1. It started off with a photograph, so the photograph is going to be the beginning. And, oops, I'm wrong on that. The poster in this case is the beginning. Sorry. And we're doing that as 5/1 because the photo was enlarged. and we want to try to find the size of the original photograph. So we're going to have to set up two proportions to do that. We have the poster. We have the photo. Bless you. We have a ratio or scale factor of 5:1 is equal to, we need to use one of these two measurements that it was enlarged to. And here's where we get our unknown. And we're going to do the same thing with the other measurement. We're going to set up a second proportion. 5:1 equals the second measurement we know over the unknown. And then we would be able to cross multiply and divide and come up with what was the size of the photo. Okay? So in some problems, you guys are going to be determining the scale factor. That's what this is doing here, where we reduced and found it. And in some situations, you're going to be comparing two things, and you're going to have to find some missing information by setting up the proportion where they give you the scale factor in the problem. And you have to cross multiply and divide to solve. Okay?